Dear listeners, tonight I will take you on a journey through the mist-covered hills and ancient valleys of the Isle of Skye, where a tale of magic, bravery, and unity unfolds. The legend of Lachlan MacLeod, a young clan chief whose quest for mystical stones leads him to confront ancient spirits and forge alliances, comes to life in a story that bridges the realms of the past and the present. Sit back, close your eyes, and let yourself be enveloped by the enchanting and timeless story of the Fog of Skye. The Fog of Skye, The Highland Mysteries. In the heart of the Isle of Skye, where rolling mists wove through the ancient hills and valleys like spectral fingers, young Lachlan MacLeod bore the weight of leadership on his broad shoulders. As the newly appointed chief of the MacLeod clan, he was acutely aware of the challenges and responsibilities that came with his title. The days were filled with the constant demands of his people, the intricate politics of clan alliances, and the ever-present threat of rival clans seeking to undermine his rule. Lachlan's mind was a tumultuous sea of worries, and he sought solace in the wild beauty of his homeland. One evening, the fog lay thick upon the land, shrouding everything in an almost supernatural stillness. The air was heavy with moisture, and the world seemed to shrink to the immediate surroundings, each footstep muffled by the dense mist. It was on such an evening that Lachlan decided to take a solitary walk along the rugged coastline, hoping the cool air and rhythmic crashing of the waves would offer him some clarity. The path was treacherous, with jagged rocks jutting out at odd angles. But Lachlan moved with the sure-footedness of one who knew the land intimately. As he walked, his thoughts drifted to the legends of his people, tales of ancient magic and powerful relics hidden within the island's depths. His ancestors spoke of a time when the land itself seemed alive with enchantment, and he wondered if there was any truth to these old stories. Lost in thought, Lachlan almost missed the narrow entrance to a cave, half concealed by a curtain of ivy and mist. Something about it caught his eye, a subtle shimmer perhaps, or a fleeting glint of light. Intrigued, and with a sense of destiny tingling in his veins, Lachlan approached the cave. He hesitated at the entrance, feeling a chill run down his spine. The air inside was cooler, the silence profound. Taking a deep breath, he stepped into the darkness, his footsteps echoing softly against the stone walls. As his eyes adjusted to the dim light, he saw the source of the shimmer, a stone, unlike any he had ever seen, resting on a natural pedestal in the center of the cavern. The stone was mesmerizing, emitting a soft, eerie glow that pulsed gently, like a heartbeat. Its surface was smooth and polished, with intricate patterns that seemed to shift and change as he watched. A strange, otherworldly aura emanated from it, drawing him closer with an almost magnetic pull. Lachlan felt his heart race, a mix of fear and fascination. He reached out a hand, compelled by an inexplicable urge to touch the stone. The moment his fingers brushed the smooth surface, the cave was flooded with an intense, otherworldly light. It was as if the stone had awakened. responding to his touch with a surge of energy. Lachlan felt the ground beneath him tremble and then dissolve, as if he were being pulled into the very fabric of the stone itself. The sensation was disorienting, and he could do nothing but surrender to the overwhelming force that seemed to envelop him. He was plunged into a vortex of swirling light and color, a tunnel that seemed to stretch on for eternity. Time lost all meaning, and Lachlan felt himself drifting, suspended in a state of pure, ethereal energy. Just as suddenly as it began, the sensation ended with a jarring thud. Lachlan found himself lying on cold, hard ground, the air filled with the cacophony of clashing swords and battle cries. Dazed and disoriented, he struggled to his feet, taking in his surroundings. He was no longer in the cave, no longer on the Isle of Skye, he knew. The landscape was foreign yet familiar, the air charged with the tension of imminent violence. He had been transported back in time, to a medieval Scotland torn by fierce clan rivalries and constant warfare. Lachlan's heart pounded as he realized the gravity of his situation. He was dressed in the garb of a Highlander, his sword at his side. The sounds of battle drew closer, and he instinctively grasped the hilt of his weapon. There was no time to ponder how or why he had been brought here. The survival instincts, honed by his years as a warrior and leader, kicked in. He had to navigate this perilous new world and find a way back to his own time. Lachlan looked around him at the disorganized situation. Warriors engaged in vicious fight, while the flags of several clans fluttered in the agitated atmosphere. It smelled so bad, like sweat and blood. Steeling himself, Lachlan realized he needed to go swiftly and aggressively. Despite not knowing this time, he was aware of the battle's regulations. He needed to find a way home, find answers, and survive. The sound of metal clanging, wounded people screaming, and the ferocious intensity of soldiers engaged in deadly conflict filled the air. Though Lachlan's heart was racing, his instincts from the battlefield and years of training soon took control. Pulling out his sword, he readied himself to defend himself. Amidst the swirling melee, Lachlan's sharp eyes caught sight of a young warrior, barely older than himself, beset by foes. The young man's back was against a large rock, his movements desperate and defensive. Lachlan did not hesitate. Charging forward, he cut through the mass of bodies, his sword moving with deadly precision. Each strike was calculated, each parry a testament to his skill. He fought his way to the embattled youth, his blade flashing in the dim light of the overcast sky. Lachlan reached the young warrior just as a particularly vicious-looking clansman raised his weapon for a killing blow. With a powerful swing, Lachlan deflected the attack and drove his sword through the assailant. The enemy fell, eyes wide with surprise, and Lachlan turned to face the next threat. Together, he and the young warrior fought side by side, their movements becoming an unspoken dance of survival and ferocity. Lachlan's presence and prowess were enough to turn the tide, and soon the attackers began to retreat, their will to fight broken. Breathing heavily, Lachlan finally had a moment to look at the young man he had saved. The warrior, though bloodied and battered, still held a fire in his eyes. He nodded his thanks, a gesture of deep gratitude and respect. "I owe you my life," the young man said, his voice steady, despite the adrenaline coursing through his veins. "I am Ewan, son of the Campbell clan leader." The revelation struck Lachlan like a thunderbolt. The MacLeods and Campbells had a long history of animosity, their relationship fraught with mistrust and bloodshed. Yet here, in the heat of battle, those old enmities seemed distant and irrelevant. Lachlan introduced himself, and though he saw a flicker of recognition, and perhaps wariness, in Ewan's eyes, the young Campbell did not hesitate to extend his hand in friendship. Despite the historic enmity between their clans, Ewan's gratitude forged an uneasy but sincere alliance. He led Lachlan through the battlefield's aftermath, weaving between the injured and the fallen. As they approached the Campbell camp, Lachlan could feel the weight of many eyes upon him. The Campbells were cautious, their gazes wary, but they did not turn him away. Ewan's endorsement carried significant weight, and Lachlan knew he had earned a fragile acceptance. The Campbell camp was a hive of activity, warriors tending to their wounds and preparing for the next inevitable conflict. Ewan brought Lachlan to a central tent where the clan leaders gathered. As they entered, the conversations hushed, and all eyes turned to the newcomers. Ewan spoke first, recounting the battle and Lachlan's decisive role in saving his life. There was a murmur of approval, but also a lingering skepticism. The Campbell chieftain, a grizzled warrior with eyes as sharp as flint, stepped forward. "You have shown great bravery, Lachlan MacLeod," he said, his voice a gravelly rumble. "For that, you have our respect and our thanks. But know this, trust is not easily given, and old wounds are slow to heal." Lachlan met the chieftain's gaze squarely. "I understand, and I ask for nothing more than the chance to prove myself. I seek answers about a mysterious stone and the path it has set me upon. I believe our fates are intertwined." There was a moment of silence as the Campbells weighed his words. Finally, the chieftain nodded. "You will stay with us then, as an ally. But remember, our trust must be earned." Lachlan accepted their terms, knowing that his survival and quest for answers depended on building a foundation of trust and mutual respect. The days that followed were filled with challenges and opportunities to prove his worth. He participated in their councils, sharing his insights and strategies, and joined them in their daily routines, from training drills to patrols. Slowly, the wary glances became nods of acknowledgement, and the cautious distance shortened. Through it all, Ewan remained at Lachlan's side, a steadfast ally and friend. The bond they had forged in the heat of battle grew stronger, and Lachlan began to see the Campbells not as enemies, but as potential partners in a shared destiny. He learned about their customs and traditions, their hopes and fears, and found common ground in their desire for peace and stability. Yet, even as Lachlan integrated himself into the Campbell clan, he never lost sight of his ultimate goal. The mysterious stone that had brought him to this time and place remained at the forefront of his thoughts. He sought out the wisdom of the elders, listened to the tales of old, and pieced together fragments of ancient knowledge. He realized that the stone was not merely a relic, but a key to something far greater, a force that could change the course of history itself. Lachlan MacLeod continued to explore the mysteries of the medieval world he had been thrown into as the days turned into weeks. The rough splendor of the Scottish Highlands served as both his haven and his testing ground. He learned that the mysterious stone he had found in the cave was actually one of several magical stones strewn over the region, all of which were protected by powerful powers and steeped in old legend. Legend had it that these stones could change history itself and even determine people's fates. Lachlan realized that finding these stones might be his only way to return to his own time and secure the future of his clan. With this knowledge, he embarked on a perilous quest, determined to uncover the secrets of the magical relics. By his side was Ewan, the son of the Campbell clan leader. Though their alliance was born of necessity, a growing camaraderie and mutual respect fortified their bond. Their journey took them through some of the most treacherous terrains the Highlands had to offer. From the mist-laden peaks of the mountains, where visibility was often reduced to mere feet, to the dense, shadowy forests that seemed to whisper of forgotten secrets, Lachlan and Ewan faced challenges that tested their resolve and resourcefulness. Each step of their quest was fraught with danger, but it was also a path of discovery and growth. The first of the stones lay hidden in the heart of a vast, ancient forest. The trees there were tall and gnarled, their branches entwined like the fingers of giants. The air was thick with the scent of pine and moss, and an eerie silence pervaded the wood, broken only by the occasional rustle of unseen creatures. As they ventured deeper, the forest seemed to close in around them, the light dimming as if reluctant to penetrate the thick canopy overhead. This is where they first came upon the first protector, an old and knowledgeable woodland spirit. The apparition of the spirit was a magnificent buck, whose antlers emitted a gentle phantom light. Its deep, wise eyes watched them with caution and interest mixed together. Lachlan and Ewan had to solve a number of puzzles that tested their understanding of nature and their cooperation skills in order to obtain the stone. Although the riddles were difficult and relied on the forest's secret wisdom, they were solved with persistence and teamwork. The second stone awaited them in a cavern high in the misty mountains. The journey to reach it was arduous, the path steep and strewn with loose rocks. The higher they climbed, the colder and thinner the air became. Lachlan and Ewan had to battle the elements, their progress hampered by sudden storms and treacherous footing. Yet, their determination never wavered. They reached the cavern, a yawning maw in the mountainside, its entrance guarded by a fierce and ancient spirit, a dragon of stone and fire. This guardian was not one to be outwitted by mere riddles. Instead, it demanded a trial of strength and bravery. Lachlan and Ewan had to face the dragon's fiery breath and navigate a labyrinth of traps and challenges within the cavern. It was a grueling test, pushing them to their physical and mental limits. Through their combined strength and unwavering resolve, they emerged victorious, the second stone claimed as their prize. Their quest led them next to the shores of a dark and mysterious loch, its waters black as night. Here, the guardian was a creature of legend, a kelpie, a water spirit known for its cunning and treachery. The kelpie appeared to them as a beautiful horse, its mane dripping with water, eyes glowing with an unearthly light. To claim the stone, they had to confront their deepest fears, as the kelpie conjured illusions that preyed upon their minds and hearts. Lachlan saw visions of his clan in ruin, his people suffering because of his absence. Ewan was haunted by the specter of failure and dishonor to his family. Together, they had to face these fears head on, grounding themselves in their friendship and shared mission. They spoke words of encouragement to each other, reinforcing their trust and determination. By breaking the kelpie's illusions, they proved their courage and integrity, earning the third stone. With each stone they acquired, Lachlan and Ewan grew closer, their bond forged in the crucible of shared trials and triumphs. The relics they sought were more than just artifacts. They were keys to understanding the deeper connections between the land, its history, and its people. Lachlan learned to respect the ancient spirits and the wisdom they guarded, realizing that his quest was as much about inner growth as it was about finding a way home. Their journey was far from over, but Lachlan felt a renewed sense of purpose and strength. He had come to see the Highlands not just as a place of danger, but as a land rich with magic and history, a land that demanded respect and understanding. With Ewan by his side, he knew they could face whatever challenges lay ahead. The quest for the magical stones was a journey of transformation, one that would shape their destinies and the fate of their clans. As the days passed, and Lachlan MacLeod and Ewan Campbell gathered more of the mystical stones, the delicate balance of power in the Scottish Highlands began to shift. The quest that had once been shrouded in secrecy became a subject of whispered conversations in the halls of power. News of their journey spread like wildfire, igniting the ambitions of rival clans who coveted the stone's legendary power for themselves. The tension that simmered beneath the surface of the Highlands erupted into open hostility, and Lachlan found himself at the heart of a brewing storm. The fragile peace that Lachlan had worked so hard to maintain was on the brink of collapse. He learned of a conspiracy among the rival clans, a sinister alliance formed with the intent to seize the stones and use their power to dominate the region. These clans, driven by greed and fear, saw Lachlan and his quest as a direct threat to their own ambitions. The realization that his mission now endangered not only his life, but the stability of the entire region weighed heavily on him. determined to avert a full-scale war, Lachlan knew he needed a plan as daring as it was decisive. He convened a secret council with Ewan and a few trusted allies. Their discussions were intense, each strategy weighed against the potential for success or disaster. The stakes were higher than ever, and Lachlan understood that he had to reveal the true power of the magical stones to unite the clans under a single banner. On the eve of the final battle, a violent storm descended upon the Highlands. The winds howled like a chorus of ancient spirits, and rain lashed the land, turning the ground to mud. The atmosphere was electric with anticipation and fear. Lachlan stood before his gathered forces, the stones secured in a chest at his feet. His face was a mask of determination, eyes blazing with the resolve of a leader ready to make a stand. As the rival clans assembled on the field of battle, the air was thick with tension. Warriors shifted uneasily, their weapons glinting in the sporadic flashes of lightning. Lachlan knew this was the moment that would determine the future of the Highlands. With a deep breath, he stepped forward and raised his voice above the roar of the storm. "Warriors of the Highlands," he began, his voice carrying through the tempest. "We stand at a crossroads. The power of these stones is not meant for domination or destruction. It is a force that binds us to the land and to each other. We have the opportunity to forge a new path, one of unity and peace." With those words, Lachlan summoned the mystical force of the stones. He drew upon their energy, feeling it surge through him like a river of light. The stones glowed brightly, their combined power creating a beacon in the storm. As he raised his arms, the energy dispersed the thick fog that had cloaked the land, revealing the true beauty and strength of the Isle of Skye. The rugged peaks, lush valleys, and sparkling waters were illuminated. A vision of the land as it could be. The rival clans, awestruck by the display of power and Lachlan's vision, hesitated. The raw, elemental force of the stones was undeniable, and for a moment, the battlefield was silent, save for the storm's fury. Lachlan's words and the undeniable power of the stones began to sway the hearts of the assembled warriors. One by one, the leaders of the rival clan stepped forward, laying down their weapons in a gesture of surrender and respect. "We pledge our loyalty to you, Lachlan MacLeod," the leader of the largest rival clan declared, his voice carrying the weight of centuries of conflict and hope for a new beginning. "Under your banner, we will strive for the peace and prosperity of the Highlands." With peace restored and the clans united, Lachlan felt a profound sense of relief and triumph. The journey had been arduous, filled with trials that tested his courage, wisdom, and resolve. But now, standing on the battlefield surrounded by his former enemies who had become allies, he knew the future of the Highlands was secure. Returning to the cave where his journey had begun, Lachlan carried the chest of magical stones. The cave, once a place of mystery and foreboding, now felt like a sacred sanctuary. The stones, glowing with a warm and steady light, seemed to pulse with approval. Lachlan placed his hand on the stone that had started it all, and in that moment, it offered him a vision of what was to come. he saw the Isle of Skye thriving under his leadership, the clans working together in harmony. The land was vibrant and prosperous, a testament to the power of unity and the wisdom of the ancients. The vision filled Lachlan with a deep sense of peace and fulfillment. He knew that the journey had been worth every hardship, every challenge. As he touched the stone once more, Lachlan felt the familiar sensation of being transported. The world around him blurred and shifted, and he found himself back in the present. The Isle of Skye was exactly as he had seen in his vision, flourishing, peaceful, and united. His clan greeted him with joy and respect, and Lachlan, now a wise and revered leader, knew that the magic and mysteries of Skye would always be a part of him. The fog that once symbolized uncertainty and danger had lifted, revealing a future filled with hope and promise. The stones had not only brought him home, but had transformed him into the leader his people needed. As he looked out over the land he loved, Lachlan MacLeod understood that the true power of the stones was not just in their magic, but in the unity and strength they had inspired. The legacy of the magical stones would endure, a beacon of hope for generations to come. And that, my dear listeners, was the Fog of Skye. Lachlan MacLeod, with courage and determination, uncovered the ancient power of the mystical relics and united the clans of the Scottish Highlands under a banner of peace. His journey through treacherous terrains, facing ancient spirits and mythical creatures, revealed a leader who could harness the true strength of his heritage. So, remember, within every challenge lies the opportunity for greatness, and in every shadow, a story waiting to be discovered. If you enjoyed tonight's enchanting tale from the heart of Old Scotland, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss a mystical story. What would you do if you found a magical stone? Would you seek its power or return to your time? Let us know in the comments below. Until next time, may you have sweet dreams and magical adventures every night.